Here we're going to take a look at an example on absolute extrema. Now, if we can go through and get all these particular parts of the problem correct, then we should have a pretty good understanding of absolute extrema. So here's the graph of some function f of x, and we're just going to ask different questions about the absolute maxes and mins on different intervals. The first one says just what's the absolute maximum period? No interval's been defined or anything like that. They just say what's the absolute maximum? This is the only question out of all the parts where different instructors may have differing opinions. Some instructors would say for part A that that's an invalid question because the answer would be different depending on where you're looking, depending on what interval we would define. You would get different answers. For instance, the absolute maximum on the interval negative 9 to 3 would be different than the max from 3 to 9. So, based off of that, they would say that this question doesn't really make sense. Many other instructors, on the other hand, would say that if an interval is not predefined, then we would be allowed to consider the entire domain. Some people also refer to the absolute maximum as the global maximum. We just look at the whole entire function and look at the highest y value that there is. So, this particular function considered that way would have an absolute maximum at 6, at the point negative 9, 6. Now, the absolute maximum specifically on the interval negative 9 to 7, negative 9 to 7, so if I only look on this window here, well, that would also be 6 because that point is within that closed interval there. All right, part C. What would be the absolute minimum, on the interval negative 9 to 3? So we're just looking at this little highlighted portion here from negative 9 to 3 and everywhere in the middle. And I'm looking for the lowest y value possible. Well, it looks like it's down here. So we'd be tempted to say negative 2, but obviously it's not defined at negative 2. So how low can we get? Well, we can get negative 1.9. Because that's obviously defined around negative 3, so we could get a y value of negative 1.9. And so then the question is that good enough? You know, would that be considered an absolute minimum? Well, if you look back at the formal definition of absolute minimum, it says that your y value is lower than every other y value on the given interval. So the question is, can I get anything lower than negative 1.9? And the answer is yes. I could get negative 1.99 or negative 1.999. And so by that argument, you could keep going on for forever. And any y value you claim would be an absolute minimum, in fact, would not be an absolute minimum because you could go a little closer to negative 2. So as far as the absolute minimum on this interval, we would unfortunately have to say that there is none. Right, and then lastly, the absolute minimum on the interval negative 3 to 7. Absolute minimum from negative 3 right here to 7. That's right there. It looks like right here at this endpoint at 7, we would get an absolute minimum. That's the lowest y value in the interval, and it is defined there. So we would get an absolute min of negative 5.